Hey guys, welcome to another Chatty Get Ready with me, and this time around I'm going to be using some new products, so it's also going to be a sort of a first impression video. I'll be using the Huda Beauty Electric Obsessions palette as well as my brand new Zoeva brush set. It's the rose gold collection that comes in this pouch, so let's get on with it. Okay, so I'm actually gonna start with eyeshadow because I don't know if this is gonna have any fallouts. The eyeshadow that I will be using today is the Huda Beauty Electric Obsessions palette that I have bought from Sephora here in Australia. If you guys haven't seen what this looks like, it is this one right here. Okay, I've never used this before. It's gonna be the first time. I have swatched it, and I'm gonna like put in the clip for the swatches somewhere in the video. But yeah, so far I haven't really actually used it on my eyes, and I will do that right now. I'm also going to be testing out the Zoeva rose gold brushes that I have actually bought, and also for the first time, so let's see how this goes. Yeah, and if you're wondering, yes, I did shave, get my hair done again, and the sides and the back are shaved. I pretty much have an undercut, so we'll get that sorted out in a little bit. Okay, so I'll get started with primer, and the primer that I'm going to be using is the Milani eyeshadow primer. I've got here my Hourglass ambient edit palette. I'm going to be using the mirror on here because this is just larger and it just like looks better. So I'm going to use that, but first off we'll start with our lovely Milani eyeshadow primer. Now this primer is not the best primer I've ever used. My favorite is still the NARS eyeshadow primer, the one that comes in the black and white packaging, because that, when I use that, I am assured that my eyeshadow will stay on for at least 14 hours. Okay, this one gives me an 8-hour work day kind of thing when I'm not doing anything and I'm just really in the office sitting down in an air-conditioned environment where humidity and heat is not affecting my eyeshadows anyway. There you go. I've also got SPF on my skin because I was actually going to go and work out today, hence the sports bra. But I somehow have lost my membership card to the gym, so I'm going to have to figure out, well, first going to try and find it. If I can't find it, I'm going to have to figure out how I can get a replacement for it. Now, what I'm going to do is actually going to bring you guys closer so that you can see what I'm actually doing with my eyes. And I'm going to talk about which brushes I'm using as well. Okay, so to set the primer that I've put on, I'm going to use my Sigma Tapered Highlighter F35 and my Hourglass Dim Light. And just really pat that on the lids to help the eyeshadows blend. And I do this, I've been actually doing this for the past maybe month and a half, and it seems to be really good in creating that transition and so that the eyeshadows blend better and slide on better. So again, I don't really know what I'm going to start with, but I am really wanting to use this sort of like blue purple shade in here. There is no name for the shades, so I'm just going to point it out. It's going to be this one. And I think the base that I'm going to be using is maybe a little bit of this orange shade right here. I'm going to put that in the crease. I'm going to be using the Zoeva 228 Luxe Crease Brush for that. So, ooh, looks really pigmented. It picks up a lot of powder. So just applying that in the crease area. This brush is amazing. It's not scratchy at all. Like, I bought the Delium brushes at the last IMATS here in Sydney, and they're all quite scratchy. Like these three here are Delium brushes. Two are quite scratchy. The pencil brush is all right, I guess. Okay, the face brushes that I bought were okay, like these two are okay, but like the eye brushes, they're really scratchy. This one, I don't feel any scratch at all. Okay. You know what I'm gonna do? I think I'm going to do one eye first so that we don't run out of time or don't go on for too long. So after this one, I'm just gonna continue doing one eye. Okay, so I've got, that's a really nice orange peach shade. Because I'm thinking, doesn't orange counteract blue or purple? So that's why I thought, let's go with that. Now, I'm going to go with the Luxe Smoky Shader 234 and that blue shade right there. I'm going to see how that's going to apply. And this isn't foiled, mind you. Oh, wow. I don't know if you guys can see that. I'm gonna scooch a little bit closer. But it's really pretty. I bet if I foil this, this is going to look even more gorgeous. Okay, now because I'm gonna use this as foil, so I'm gonna change brushes and I'm gonna use the 226 Smudger, which is a synthetic bristle. I think these ones are synthetic too, but they're like, I don't know. I could be wrong. So I'm gonna go ahead and get that blue shade. And I'm gonna take my Urban Decay All Nighter setting spray. And then apply that onto the lid. Gorgeous. Wow. That really intensifies this shade. You see that? And it's a beautiful blue that's not like the electric blue that you see often. It's got a hint of purple in it. Okay, so that, I'm gonna just swish that into my brush cleaner. And then I'm gonna go in with, I don't know. I'm thinking a little bit of this like matte teal here with the Zoeva Soft Luxe Definer. See how that goes. Ooh, picks. The matte ones are really powdery, like they pick up quite a lot. So this is just essentially diffusing the shades and creating a little bit of a dimension. But what I've also noticed is that the blue shade, the metallic blue shade, disappears. So they're kind of like, you see that? Now the blue ones are all underneath my eyes. I'm gonna go back with that crease brush and that orange shade because I seem to have lost some of that depth. Okay, and I'll soften the whole thing as well. Okay, that's kind of how that's gonna look. I don't know, I'm not entirely convinced. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna fix my brows and I'm gonna do the other eye as well. I'm gonna finish the whole eye look and tell you what else I've put in there, and then I'll come back. All right, so I'm sort of finished with the eyes. I used my Lancome liquid pencil eyeliner, and this is the best eyeliner for the waterline that I found on my lower lash line and as a tight line. I used that. I used my YSL. What is this called? Mascara volume. This is just a deluxe sample. I use that on my lashes, and I've put on my Daiso eyelashes, which is what you're seeing, is just sort of a demi-wispy kind of thing. Now, I said I was going to do my brows, but I decided that I wasn't going to do that because I do have a brow brush right here. It's the 322 brow brush from Zoeva, and I'm going to use it to do my brows. So let's see. Oh, and I also, by the way, used another shade from the Huda Beauty. This purple shade at the top, I put it like at the center of the lids. I don't know if you can actually see the difference, but it like sort of creates some dimension. So moving on, brows. I've got my Anastasia Dip Brow Pomade in dark brown. I keep forgetting. And it's on this little thing here. This brush is so stiff that you could definitely create like a really straight, because I don't have brows in some places, but wow. I usually use my Tarte brow with a brush with a spoolie, which came with my purchase of their pomade. But this is doing really well, and that was pretty quick and precise. Wonder if I can extend it a little bit. Oh, it actually even does a great job of doing that. Wow, didn't expect that. Okay, let's like straighten this bottom area a little bit more. I'm happy with that. Okay, I'll do the other brow and get back to you guys. Well, that certainly did a pretty good job with my brows. Now let's go on with the base. I'm going to be using this brush here called the Defined Buffer Brush, number 103. It's really freaking soft, man. and I'm going to be using my Estee Lauder Perfectionist Youth Infusing Serum Makeup. But this is pretty matte for the winter, so I'm actually going to mix it with the Backlight Priming Filter. Excuse me. And that's what we're going to do. So I've got the Backlight Priming Filter at the back of my hand now. I'm going to squeeze out 1.5 pumps off the Estee Lauder foundation. Mix that with my fingers. Okay. Now when I use my beauty blender, and I use it quite often, I use about one pump because, well, I just do. And I like the light coverage that it gives me. But let's see how much coverage this brush is going to give me with this foundation. Okay. So got a few at the back. Not covering the nick on my chin, but then that's probably the foundation, not really the brush. The handle is so long, it's hitting my mirror. But it's thin enough or slim enough that it can go in between my brows. However, I do feel that it's taking it longer to blend in the foundation on my face than a beauty blender normally would. Because with my beauty blender, I'm normally finished by now. But it's not the case for this. Still have a little bit of foundation left, so I'm just gonna take that underneath my eyes, but I'm still gonna use a concealer. And I realized I hadn't put anything on my nose as well. So there. It gives me this about the same coverage as my Beauty Blender does, but it just takes longer. I don't know if I'm gonna want to use this in place of my Beauty Blender. What I do notice though is up close, my foundation seems to be a bit more thick. Like it didn't really blend properly, it's just sitting on there. I'm just gonna get my Real Techniques sponge. And I can see from the sponge, it's picking up a little bit of that foundation. Especially on my forehead. May have placed way too much foundation on there. But it does give an even application, so yeah, it's okay. Just don't know if I'm gonna be grabbing this quite often. Now for concealer, because it's winter, I'm not using my MAC. What's that called? I forget what it's called. But my MAC concealer palette, I actually use my favorite Maybelline Fit Me concealer. This is in the number 25. Which gives me a little bit of brightening under the eyes. So I usually do that and that. And again, I normally use my Real Techniques sponge for this application, but today I've got the concealer buffer, number 142, so I'm just gonna use that. See how it goes. Now, Real Techniques has something similar to this. I do have it somewhere. It's like the rounded one. That does a good job. I do like that it's small enough to get into like the inner corner and so much closer to the lash line. And actually go into like the creases to make sure that there are no settling of concealer there. However, I don't find that this blends it properly. Because as you can see, it's still like... So again, I'm gonna go back in with my sponge and just press it down. Okay, so that it blends together with the foundation that I've put on. Okay, so far so good. Now I'm going to take the pencil brush here and I'm going to go back with that Huda Beauty Electric Obsessions. And I think I'm going to go with this shade here. You can see my camera right there. And use that underneath the lash line to, one, blend out the black eyeliner that I've placed in there, which I should have done before. That's okay. I'm liking that combination actually. Okay, I know I don't actually see it seems that the eyeshadow is not as vibrant on the eyes as they are on the pan or when swatched. I mean, I don't hate the look that I created, but I thought that that was going to be a little bit more, you know, boom. But it's not. Now let's go and move forward to the face. I am going to go ahead and get my Hourglass Ambient Light in Radiant Light. I was using the dim light for my lids earlier. This is the 106 powder brush that also comes in that... Words, Meg. Anyway, I'm just using that to set my foundation, which sets pretty easily anyway. But this really gives my skin really beautiful sheen. And then I'm actually going to go in again with the dim light one and that Sigma highlighter brush and bring that underneath the eyes. You can see the beautiful sheen on my face. Okay. Now I'm going to go in with my ambient edit. This is the first version. And I'll talk about this in a different video. Anyways, I'm going to go in with the bronzer shade here. Take that there. With that powder brush. Okay. I'm going to go in with the fan brush and this shade here, which is called Diffused Light. Place that on. Is it even picking up anything? Okay, there it is. Okay, I'm gonna go in with this sheer cheek and I'm gonna go in with, this is called Luminous Flush. It's probably not showing much on camera. I'm going to go in with a Luxe Face Paint. I'm going to take that bronzer shade again and bring that to the sides of my nose. Needs to blend a little bit. Put on a lipstick and I'm gonna spritz my face with my all-nighter spray and that'll be the end of it. Alrighty, so here is the finished look. For the lips, I have the Ofra Kathleen Lights collaboration called Havana Nights. That's what's on my lips right now and that is the entire look as you have seen me do here. Now, probably the first thing that I'm gonna do or gonna review is the Huda Beauty Electric Obsessions. I just wanted to really talk about this and say that, I don't know, I have to use it a little bit more, but on first impression, I thought that it was going to be a bit more vibrant and pigmented because on here, it just looks pretty awesome, but on the lids, it seems to not have that same vibrancy and opacity. This green or this teal shade right here actually looks a little bit meh and kind of like disappears as I blended it out. I don't really see much of it left on my lids. I'm gonna have to try it a little bit more, but so far I find that the mattes kick up a lot of powder. It's a bit soft, but it's very easy to blend. Particularly this orange shade right here, that was pretty easy to blend. I have no issues with that. The shimmery shades work really well foiled. If you don't foil it, there's really not much of an impact. I don't see how it is any more unique than any other shades, honestly, or any other brands that have shimmery shadows that are of the same color. In fact, I think my Makeup Forever Artie shadow palettes have more impact when they're not foiled than these ones even after they're foiled. So I don't know, this was I think $48 here in Australia. It's 20 something I believe in the States, 27 if I'm not mistaken. So because I don't have any other products that are similar to these shades, I will keep it, and I think I will have some use out of it. But other than that, oh, I also need to mention that this shade right here, I washed my the brush that I used for it, the pencil brush from Zoeva, and it kind of stained it. Even after even the blue one here, this one here, the teal, stained my brushes. So I'm not very happy with that, I'll be honest. Even after, I usually wash my brushes with the Daiso brush cleaner, and that works pretty well. But this time around, I had to double cleanse it with the Dr. Bronner's castor soap, and there's still some left. Okay, speaking of brushes, I used majority of these Zoeva brushes, and now I have washed them. They're very soft. I do really, really like them. The goat hair ones, the white bristled ones, tend to stain, especially with like reddish shades, so just be aware of that. I used the Dr. Bronner's castor soap, and it pretty much went off, but there's still a bit of shade left in there. There is also a little bit of shedding on the goat hair ones. The synthetic ones proved to be quite good. I really like the eyebrow brush that I use today. Now, as for which ones I think I would be using the most, I think I do enjoy the powder brush that I used, the brow brush, and most of the eye brushes, actually all of the eye brushes that I used, I do really like. As for the foundation brush, the definer, what's it called? Definer brush. I didn't really like that. The cheek blush is okay. Not really, you know, mind-blowing. What else was there? The concealer brush, I don't think I'm going to actually be using that for concealer. I think more like to set the primer that I have, or maybe even the concealer if I use concealer on my lids. But other than that, yeah, those are my reviews. I still have three brushes that I haven't used, which is their winged liner. I also have the spot liner here and the face curve, which I don't really know what to do with. It looks pretty much like the traditional foundation paddle brush, but just in a different shape. So maybe I will try and use this for foundation or concealer and see how that goes. And I'll keep you obviously updated. Now the question now is, now that I have actually washed these, are they going to stay in their shape? So what I would probably do is put them back into their containers when they are still damp but not actually wet anymore to get them to stay in their actual shapes. So that's my get ready with me first impression slash review kind of thing for these two products. Now I still have the gravity paste hair from Hans DeFuco and the Marc Jacobs eyeshadow palette that I need to review. I would probably do a mixed review after the brushes have dried and I've used the Huda Electric Obsessions palette more. I have been using the Marc Jacobs one quite often, so I actually already have an opinion about that. And I also will feature a gift from a friend of mine. It's the Guerlain Terracotta Mineral Bronzer in 01. I haven't used this today, but I will include it in the review because I have been using it on a daily basis at work. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. It's a little bit long, but there you go. I'll see you on the next video. If you haven't subscribed, please do click on the subscribe button down below. You can also click on the notification bell right next to it so that you are updated as to when I upload my videos. And that's usually on Sunday, Tuesdays, and Thursdays. Thanks for watching. Bye.